Good evening and welcome to the weekly Tonight Show with Karlos. Tonight, live from his rented mansion overlooking the pristine Brisbane River, please welcome, by underwhelming demand, the star of the show, Karlos.
Welcome to another show. It's great to see you at the end of another long week. Oh, long. Cabin fever, anyone? As my man DJ Fisher would say. I'm losing it. Completely cabin fevered. Hey, it's an important religious time, I know, for a lot of folks out there. So I hope you're all going well in regards to that. It reminds me of my favourite Jesus moment. Big Lebowski, watch it. It's good for you. Hey, a mate of mine also sent me some footage of the Easter Bunny. Some people aren't going to like this. I know. It's not really PG rated. But let's catch up with the Easter Bunny and see what the Easter Bunny is doing, because the Easter Bunny knows isolation for all the 364 days of the year on his own or her own. This is what he or she gets up to. So many great ads too have come in. This small business, Carl's Classifieds, we love you so much. And the ads are getting more and more creative and more out there. The more out there, I love it more. So here's the first one, boys, light it up. Anyway, Fitzy has come back for another week. He just wants to be Molly Meldrum so bad. I love you, Fitzy, so much. Here's another great review from Fitzy. I'm not sure what it is, but I know it'll be great.
Thanks a lot, Carlos. Pay your invoice from last week, you dog. This week's album review, can I just say last week's, the Chats, they went to number one. Well done, boys. And I'm pretty sure these boys will go to number one as well. Violent Soho, their new one, everything is A-OK. Can we take it? Been a few years for the lads. Great to have you back. I love this band. I've been stalking this band for many a year, and I'll tell you right now, I'll continue to do so.
Actually, Fitzy, just on that one, we've just had the protection order approved, and you now have to stay 200 metres away from the band.
James Fitzgerald, mate, massive fan. Well done on the album. It's brilliant.
Also says here, you need to stay 200 metres away from the album.
Seriously? Can I at least give it a review?
No.
Is one of the Lukes there, mate? Can I speak to one of the Lukes?
Mate, here's a sentence I've never used. I'm calling the cops.
Second album this week, Pearl Jam's got a new one. It's called Gigaton. And if you want to kick in the teeth, have a listen to the riff from this first song, Whoever Said. Tip one, in isolation moshing. If somebody hits the deck, there's only one thing to do, isn't there, Lenny?
I've hit the deck, help me up! Give him room, get him up!
Oh. Help out your mates, get him up, and I'll give you another tip next week. I give Violent Soho 4.5 out of 5, and I give Pearl Jam's 4 out of 5. Back to you, Carlos.
One of you rascals out there also sent me this great video of their dad this week. I lost it completely, and you should have a look right now.
My way of helping the coronavirus with a bit of public service, we can all help by doing this every morning. Ready? You may think what I'm doing, is slowing the spread. All right? And here's another one I've worked on. Look. See? Flattening the curve. See, we all got our part to play.
How good is that fella? I just want to run my fingers through his beard. Let's catch up with the Easter Bunny again. My second out of the week comes from the Goldie in lockdown. Hasn't there been some focus on the Goldie? The issue is, when you lock people down on the Gold Coast, weird stuff happens. Have a look at this video. While a mate of mine was recording a video for Carl's Classifieds, watch what happens in the background.
Absolutely rip. And between... an idiot! Oh, Jesus Christ! Put f***ing clothes on! Get out. My neighbour, naked. There we go.
Further south, Bondi's been an absolute cluster again, hasn't it? Empty beaches and everyone, all you little party animals inside your apartments, we know what you're up to. So my man Danny Clayton went out to see what he could find out. Yeah. He's watching you.
Hello, Carlos. Danny Clayton here, coming to you live from Sydney's cesspool of infection, otherwise known as Bondi. Look, I'm doing well in ISO, besides the fact that I haven't worn pants in about a week. But it's okay, because Monty, your producer, if we can call him that, contacted me to see how I was, and he asked if I could get him some footage of Bondi Beach just to check that no one is on it. Now, I can't leave the house because of the isolation laws, but I did come up with an alternative.
Okay.
I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky.
Crony Boy 1 making first pass over Bondi. No hipsters inside. No hipsters inside. Sending Drone Boy back to base.
Thank you, Danny. A few short messages from the Prime Minister of the country now.
Andrew, I'm sorry, you've had several questions. Andrew, I know, but you don't run the press conference, okay? So I'm going to go to other questions of members of the group. Catherine hasn't had a question. I'm happy to return to you, but let's just keep it civil. Andrew. Catherine.
How good was that, huh? Easter Bunny? Where you at? My man Tim Blackwell also bothered the hell out of me this week to try and be part of this show because... Nah, he didn't. Anyway, I asked him to do some fitness because Timmy Blackwell is really into his fitness, believe it or not. So he sent me his workout regime. Check it out.
201. Thanks, Carlos. I'm here to keep you mentally fit and physically charged during this time of crisis. So what you'll need is your favourite snack, hydration, and ideally a yoga instructor wife. Looking good, babe.
Now this is what Timmy thinks he looks like at 3 in the morning.
That's it. Move. That's it. Move your hip. Come on.
Guys, that's it for this week. I hope it brought you a little laugh wherever you are across this great country of ours. To our doctors and nurses and our emergency services working on the front line this Easter, hope you have a great one. Hope you get to spend some time with your family. We'll all get through this together, won't we? We'll see you again soon.
It's the end of the world as we know it. Life feels